So, hello everybody. My name is Sergey Chernyshev. I work for Central Aerohydrodynamic Institute in Moscow. Area of my study is acoustic radiation by subsonic turbulent jet. There are many important applications. Most known of them is aviation noise control. It is a classic problem. Nevertheless, there are unsolved questions like this: what aspect of turbulent pulsation in a jet is responsible for the sound radiation? After brief introduction, I will stop on the standard approach to the problem, then measurements, and then a proposed stochastic model to overcome some problems. General solution of aeroacoustic problem was done in 1970 by Crow. For the low Mach number and acoustically compact flow, he showed that the turbulent flow as a whole can be regarded as a source of sound with quadrupole moment calculated from incompressible dynamics. So the task divided in two parts. First of all, in calculation of incompressible dynamics, and then a calculation of sound. Of course, we can be interested in the details of sound sources. So can we extract local turbulent events as independent sound sources? The answer is yes, but there is some problem because local event in vortex dynamics in some point is accompanied by in-phase disturbances of surrounding vorticity field in mixing layer. And both of them radiate sound. The self-sound by the event itself, and the secondary, the so-called shear noise, radiated by in-phase disturbances. So aim of our study is correct modeling of the shear noise, this part, radiated by turbulence mixing layer. Let's continue with the standard approach to this problem. In this approach, the first step is averaging of turbulent mixing flow, and as a result, we have average shear flow. Then we look at the disturbances excited with some unsteady source in this flow, and noise generated by the disturbances of the mean flow is regarded as shear noise. It can be represented in terms of disturbances of vorticity, then the quadrupole moment of all of this situation can be departed in two parts. The quadrupole moment of the self noise, the event itself, and the quadrupole moment of shear noise that is can be represented as a function of disturbances of vorticity. The result for the point quadrupole source, external source in the mixing layer, harmonic and time, is presented here. We in 2D flow, we have two different possible quadrupoles, and one of them produce the shear noise and the other no. Then we continue with the measurements. There are a lot of measurements of jet noise, but most interesting and detailed of them are obtained with arrays of microphones. For example, with circular air, we can decompose the jet noise on different azimuthal harmonics, and it is very interesting information. For example, here we can see the acoustic noise directivity for different harmonics. Here, acoustic radiation power depending on jet axial coordinate x. This is three azimuthal harmonics, and different curves correspond to different frequency band. And this is very good rich data for theory validation. Of course, theory that we can compare with the measurements is a little bit more complicated than than spoken above. Nevertheless, we can in 3D green function for different quadrupoles, 3D quadrupoles, we can separate the self noise radiated by the source itself and the shear noise components that relates with the disturbances in the surrounding vorticity field. And only two quadrupoles have shear noise term and the other not. So if we compare the prediction model prediction and measurements, then we can see very good agreement in wide range of parameter for different velocities, for different angles, and so on. But this is model without shear noise. Shear noise is not included here. And if we include the shear noise term, then the comparison is corrupted. So do we understand right the self, the shear noise phenomenon? To make this more clear, we consider the stochastic model of the shear noise. When the turbulent pulsation in the jet achieve a high amplitude, then the velocity field splits into something like vortex worms. This is vortex lines. Does this vorticity disintegration influence on the sound generation condition? Here in this work, we restrict with 2D model. So the standard approach, what is standard approach spoken above? It is averaging of background flow on the first step and calculation of shear noise of the linear disturbances of this mean flow on the second step. Let's go inverse order. So at first we calculate the shear noise but this system of vortices, and then average the result over the vortex locations. We would like to see, is there any difference between these two approaches? Here we again we restrict with 2D model of mixing layer. We neglect the non-uniformity along the axis, x-axis, consider the uniformly distributed point vortices in the strip, in the infinite strip, and if the system of vortex is rather dense, then we can consider this system as a system in equilibrium for for some for sufficient time for our purpose. Then we should consider the forcing of the system of point vortices by some external source. If dynamics of the vortices is determined by interaction between them and the effect of external source. If we consider the small disturbances, so the vortex displacement due to external source is much less than the distance between the vortices, then we can obtain a linear equation for the vortex displacement, small vortex displacement. After that, we can calculate the shear noise quadrupole moment, that is quadrupole moment corresponding to the effect of forcing of this system. And then we should average this expression for the shear noise quadrupole. Let's divide the shear noise quadrupole in two parts, this first and second. The second part can be averaged over vortex location directly, but as for the first part, it is not so easy because this part is a function of vortex displacement depending on the history of the whole system. To overcome this problem, we can consider the forcing of system by impulse source. And just after the impulse delta function of time. And just after this impulse, the displacement of vortices is a function of their own location. In addition, we use the Taylor's series expansion for the quadrupole moment at times after impulse. So we should average the Taylor series coefficients instead averaging of the quadrupole itself. Then we can organize recurrent procedure. Fortunately, all the derivatives are equal to zero. So what does it mean? It means that as a result, we have following expression for the component of shear noise component. What does it mean? It means that average quadrupole moment values are constant of motion for the linear disturbances of this system. Using this, we can obtain the solution for the point quadrupole source inserted in the system of point vortices. And source is harmonic in time. This is for two possible quadrupole moment of the source itself. We have two solutions for the shear noise component. If we compare the results for the standard approach and the stochastic standard approach mentioned above and stochastic model proposed in this work, we see the difference. This is only simplified 2D model, and to to solve what model is better, we need to compare with the experiment, and of course we can develop the model to 3D case. Nevertheless, we can see that more accurate considering of the reaction of the mixing layer to the quadrupole source show that primary average of the flow, like in standard approach, leads to incorrect result. We can conclude first the standard description of shear noise is incorrect due to primary averaging of the background flow. Correct calculation of shear noise radiated by turbulent mixing flow includes averaging, should include averaging at the final step. Obtained results show possible cause of the disagreement between experiment and theory for the jet noise azimuthal harmonics. As for perspective, studies of 3D model for the 3D stochastic model are ongoing. Thank you for attention.
What do you think about the new methods for minimization of jet noise? Because I know there are different kind of plasma source to minimization, so on.
You mean methods of noise control? In our group in SAGIA, we do with that topics, of course, with the experiment with the jet noise, with plasma method as well. As for plasma, I should say that the result was achieved when plasma actuators force the jet on the some high frequency, then in the low frequency range, the most important for practice, it is attenuation of low frequency spectra due to that. So it is it is far from practice application, but nevertheless it is something.
Maybe it's not used another kind of plasma. Maybe it's possible usual spark something. Not DBD, dielectric barrier discharge, but maybe usual. I know you.
Simple sparks. You mean?
Yeah. Because it's not destroyed some vortex. It's very simple idea.
Yeah, there are many direction from corrugated shape of the nozzle itself to forcing of the jet by. As for sparkles, I didn't know this works. We deal with plasma.
I tried to do it.
Yeah.
Excuse me.
Okay.